Hi guys, welcome to Code Debugger. Today we are going to implement JavaX validation with Spring Boot implementation. So JavaX validation is a standard API provided by Java people as part of JSR 380. So this is also known as bin validation. There are so many implementations are provided by multiple vendors, but we are going to use the Hibernate provided implementation in our application. So let's start as usual with Spring initializer. So let's go to Spring initializer start.spring.io. So project name is Spring Boot hyphen JavaX validation. We'll select the Java version as 8. Add a dependency with web dependency. Let's generate the project. Project downloaded. Let's extract the project. Okay, so let's import in IntelliJ. Yeah, Maven structure is ready. Okay, this is the main class. So, as I said before, we are going to use the Hibernate implementation for the JavaX validation. Let's search the Hibernate dependency for that. Hibernate validator Maven dependency. Okay, let's this is the final version we are using. Okay, 6.1.5. Let's add that into the pom.xml dependency section. Added import. So I guess imported successfully. Let's see. Okay, JavaX. Hibernate validator is available here. Okay. Let's create a controller class. Create a package controller. Let's create a class. Let's say message controller. We'll annotate this as a REST controller. Method public string send OTP, let's say. Here we are going to take one mobile number, let's say, and this will pass as a request parameter. After get mapping, send OTP, will return, let's say. If you OTP sent successfully. So till now we have not used JavaX validation. So let's see what is the problem we are facing and why we should use the JavaX validation here. So let's see. Let's start the application and we'll see. So yeah, application is getting up. Yeah, Tomcat 8080 port. let's go to the postman. HTTP 80/sendOTP, I guess. Let's see. Send OTP. Sorry, I forgot to give slash. Okay. Send OTP. And you need to pass one parameter, mobile number. Mobile number is equal to, let's see, which we are passing as a mobile number. If you see here, this is giving 200 successful and message as OTP sent successfully. But this is not a mobile number, right? So we need to validate the mobile number as well. That means the mobile number should be 10-digit mobile number. How we can validate that? We can write the business logic for that. We can validate that. But why you should go to business layer? If you are, we can manage that in controller layer itself. So how we can manage that? Let's go and try this. Okay. We have added the hibernate validator, the implementation class of JavaX validation here. Okay. So here what we are going to see, here we will use pattern validation. If you see here, JavaX that validation.constraint, the pattern is coming. Okay, so here regex you need to pass. Suppose some regex will pass here, and the message. What is the message we are going to pass? Let's say message is mobile number should be 10 digit. So what is the regex for the 10 digit mobile number? So regex for the mobile 10 digit mobile number is, we need to pass the digit and we need to pass 10 digit, right? So this is the regex for 10 digit mobile number. If you see, we have added the dependency, we have added the annotation here, but we need to enable that. Validated, Spring has provided this validation automatically. Java will enable this pattern validation. Let's see. Let's start the application and we'll see. Okay, now application is up and running. Let's go to the postman. Let's pass. If you see, we are getting 500 internal server error, but we are not getting any meaningful message, right? It is just throwing one exception to us. That means Spring is throwing this exception to us. That means in this path, we are getting some exception, that is 500 internal server error. Let's go to the console and we'll see what is the exception it is throwing. Okay. If you see here, JavaX validation it is throwing the exception, and OTP dot mobile number, OTP method and mobile number is the parameter, and the message is mobile number should be 10 digit. Okay, so how we can manage this? How we can handle this? Spring is throwing this exception. That means we need to implement controller advice for this. Send the meaningful message to the user. So let's implement the controller advice for this. Let's say exception. So let's create a class app exception handler. So every exception handler should annotate with @regex controller advice. So public, let's say I will return response entity. So I will return, because if you see here, we are returning 500 internal server error, but in my case we will return 400 bad request. Okay, let's see how to return that. I'll pass string as a body. Handle constraint about lesson system. अपने एक्सेप्शन हैंडलर कंस्ट्रेंट वायलेट्स एन एक्सेप्शन डॉट क्लास means this exception, whenever this exception will come, automatically this method will get called. Okay. Let's try it then. Response entity dot bad request will return dot body as what will pass as a body, whatever returning, whatever we are message we are passing here, that message we should get here, right? So exception dot get constant violations dot iterator dot next dot get message. So we'll return this one. So we have implemented the rest control advice for this. Let's start the application and we'll see whether we have manage the exception or not. Okay, now started. Let's see. Yep. See here. We are sending one meaningful SMS like message like mobile number should be 10 digit. Whatever we are passing message, that message we are getting, right? So this is the way how we can manage the exceptions or constraint violation exceptions in our application. This is the way we can handle the JavaX validations. So there are different annotations are there, like @NotNull is there, @NotEmpty is there, different are there. And if you see, this is this pattern validation is we can annotate that as method field, constructor parameter type, everywhere we can use. But this is only for parameter I am using, but in upcoming videos I am going to use this in different locations, so you will get the more clarity on this. Thank you for watching this video. If you have not subscribed the channel, please go ahead and subscribe the channel. Thank you.